Welcome in, everyone, to Understanding CBD episode number 42. And we're live here in the studio today, December 13th, 2020. And like we are each and every Sunday at 2 to 3 Eastern on Talk Radio WCBM, AM 680. I am Stephen Wallman.
I am Max Sobel.
And in the studio today, we have Zachary Wallman, not mic'd up yet, but if he's got something interesting to add to the conversation, we can, you know, we can bring him one. Mm-hmm. Max and I are co-founders of Max and Stephen's Premium Hemp Extracts, and together we are on a mission to be your reliable source, not only for the best hemp products out there, but also reliable information on, in, and around the cannabis plant, the endocannabinoid system, so you can live a happier, healthier, more balanced life.
That's right. That's what we do.
And before we get started, we'd like to mention that all the information discussed on this program is for general education purposes only. And you'd be crazy if you took this as professional, medical, or legal advice.
I mean, after all, we started with the Charlie Brown theme.
So,
that sets the tone, you know?
I know. And our phone number, if you want to call into the show, it's 410-922-6680. And if you're streaming live, you probably don't know that number, but the locals do. And our company phone number all day is 443-743-2444. If you want to get Max and Steven after the show, just give us a text or call. Now, that that opening song is actually, if you didn't notice the tune, is the signature melody from the Peanuts franchise.
Uh-huh.
Right, Max?
That's right.
Written by American jazz pianist Vince Guaraldi.
Hmm.
And that was the Vince Guaraldi Trio, and the song titled Linus and Lucy. And this is actually kicking off our pet episode.
I love it.
So
I love it. What a choice. Didn't expect that at all.
And actually, when we were at the farmer's market this past season, actually, by everyone, we won't be there anymore. We finished and retired our 2020 season. But we actually met Charlie Brown's teacher there, didn't we?
We did. We met Charlie Brown's teacher.
She came over and she said to Max,
it might have had something to do with the fact that she was wearing a mask, but we could have sworn it was Charlie Brown's teacher.
It sounded just like her.
Wah, 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 wah.
Right. And somehow Max understood. He said, yeah, here it is. It's you can take normal servings, start slow and low, you know. We're also going to talk about some dosing and servings today, but you're going to love our lineup we have on the show today. We're going to do some things we've never done before. Number one is we are videotaping the show.
We are video recording the show.
How do you feel about that, Max?
I feel very interesting about that. Not only was it an interesting setup, but talk about being vulnerable. Although I will tell you that this videoing was a little bit more comfortable than the videoing we did the other day, huh?
Yeah.
Sitting up on chairs in front of lights like a couple of gargoyles.
Yeah, you know? So for those listening, we are working on some videos to help us inform and educate consumers about our brand, as well as healthcare professionals, a short 90-second video, but the part that we're contributing to it was filmed the other night in a studio behind in a green screen. And if anyone knows Max or I, we're not professionally trained actors.
Right. We kind of felt like
you
we
may
were
be
walking.
Surprised by this. But
we kind of felt like we were walking into a creepy porn shoot, if you want to know the real truth about it. But nevertheless, I mean, the fact that we're filming here is really cool because this is actually going to be, we're going to be putting this on our YouTube channel, right?
Yes. Okay. Yes. And we're doing this because we have to find a way to reach people, right?
Yeah.
I mean, we want to reach more people than we can without this.
And absolutely.
Because we can't do the face-to-face events anymore, you know.
Yeah, we want people to see our faces. I mean, that's the thing. I mean,
for some reason.
Yep, no face-to-face events. I mean, the feedback that we get from the people is that they want to see us face-to-face. They want to be able to interact with us. I mean, they want to make it personal, and we want to make it personal for them.
Yes. And on that line, we're going to introduce everyone to a new team member we have, and we're going to get right to that. But before we do, our special guest and friend, Shorty Rossi, is going to be here today. He's a star of Animal Planet's Pit Boss. Some of you may remember that show. Owner of Shorty's Rescue. It's a beautiful story. This guy is giving back like people say they are grateful and they want to give back. You know, he runs an adoption agency, and when you adopt a pet from him, if you're not taking care of it, he's coming to take it back.
Oh yeah, he's coming to get
you. How did you meet him, Max? And how did that come down?
I think it was about a year ago, and we'll call it BC, before COVID. We were still having events, and it was the World of Pets Expo, and I remember meeting him. What a great guy. I mean, just he gets approached by everybody, and I mean, the fact that he was willing to sit there and meet me, have a chat with me, I mean, just a real personable guy. We got to know him, and then we started talking with him a little bit more after that, and he's just a fantastic person. Honestly, that's how I met him, and that's how we got him on the show, and I'm thrilled.
That's awesome. So he will be joining us after this break. We're excited to have him on here. Doc G has the week off, actually serving as a, on a wellness panel as a presenter. And he sends his love and well wishes.
Maybe maybe nursing a hangover after that Army win over Navy, I think. Yeah. He's probably happy about that.
I'm sure he is. And he'll be back next week, and we can't wait to hear what he's got for us and learn from the segment.
Yep.
We finish off as everyone's favorite segment that is known as...
Ailsack!
All right.
That's Noah in the mothership today, baby. There
right.
you go.
Noah's back. Uh-huh. Noah's back. So let's talk about... So we're going to talk about pets today. And just to give some people some really quick context, there are a lot of pets in and pet owners in the U.S. And it's something like around 67... Two out of every three... homes actually have pets. Did you know that, Max?
Yeah, and more people getting pets every single day, especially now.
Yes, and you know, the numbers are actually staggering. There's a study from the American Pets Products Association that 85 million homes in America.
85 million.
And the breakdown is 63.5 million are dog owners, 42.5 million are cat owners, 11.5 are freshwater fish.
Freshwater fish. Interesting.
Yes, and actually tied for 1.6 million are horses and saltwater fish.
It's interesting that horses and saltwater fish are tied, and freshwater fish, for whatever reason, are more popular.
So if you own a saltwater fish, you may want to reach out to horse owners. Maybe you have something in common.
Well, so that makes sense now, because we walk a lot around our neighborhood, and not only do we see a lot more dogs, but maybe people are walking their freshwater fish, too. I mean, who knows? Maybe they have it in their pocket attached to a leash. I don't know.
Yeah, you know. Well, people spend a lot of money, too.
More money on their pets than anything else.
Last year... the survey shows almost $96 billion.
Yeah, and then after we looked at that statistic, to 2020, there's almost 100 million, 99 billion, sorry, with a B, estimated is what people will spend on their pets. Amazing.
That's right, and pets are good for us, too. So they help us decrease blood pressure, cholesterol levels, triglycerides, help the feeling of loneliness,
anxiety, stress.
Look at it's very serendipitous, and they do that, and that's why we like to give back. Mac, you're a volunteer, aren't you?
Yeah, admittedly, I haven't been there in a little while because of COVID and all, but yes, I volunteered at Baltimore Humane Society. They're a fantastic organization here locally, by the way, and if anybody would like to get in touch with them, their number is 410-883-8848. I know that they're always looking for help and donations, so don't be shy. If you have anything extra or anything you can offer, please reach out to them.
That's awesome. And fantastic. No, so we want to introduce you to this new team member, and we're not sure if the technology can work on the phone call. So she pre-recorded a recording to introduce herself to the listeners.
Mm-hmm.
And Noah, let's see what Jade has to say.
Hey, everyone. So it's Jade Laws here, new team member, as you'll soon find out. It's an honor to be featured on the show today and to even be working alongside Max and Steven so closely. So thank you guys for giving me that opportunity. I think Max and Steven will agree to this, but it's taken quite the journey to get to this point. We've had our fair share of ups and downs so far, but I think any good relationship starts off with challenges. So, you know, I've basically a bit about me, but I've worked with some of the top brands and industry leaders in cannabis in the world. And it was a no-brainer for me to include Max and Steven in that, as well as the understanding CBD brand, you know, and there's a few reasons for that. So I actually initially came across the podcast organically, just, you know, doing some research. And the biggest standout for me was the just ridiculous amount of knowledge. Quite frankly, I've never come across guys or people in the industry that genuinely want to educate the way that these two do. It is nothing like it I've ever seen before. And then, you know, I had a further look into the brand and I just got so excited when I found out more about them, you know, their generosity and their mission to support these remarkably important causes that are actually close to my heart too. So, you know, with me looking further into the brand, and I urge you guys to look further as well, when you look further into the brand and find the nuances that make them some of the greats in the industry, it's tough not to want to work with them. And they all attest to this, but I had a heck of a lot of persistence trying to get in touch with them, trying to potentially work with them to some degree. You know, so it's quite unbelievable to see where we're at right now, where I'm kind of a part of the team, part of the family, which I'm very honored to say that I am, because I know they've breeded this incredible community with you guys that I'm so privileged to even be a part of. And I must say it has been a daunting beginning so far, just because
Can you hear me?
You know, I've never been a part of a team that literally breathes the culture of transparency and honesty like these guys have. But I think I'm up for the task. Hopefully this is the start of something great, and I hope to spread the positive message of this plant even further. And I truly do thank you guys for this opportunity, and hopefully you hear from me again soon.
How about that accent?
Yeah. Howie likes it too, right?
I think so.
Yeah, she's South African.
And let me tell you a story about how we met her real quick. So she was really persistent, and a lot of companies reach out to us on a regular basis to try to get our attention. Well, her persistence paid off. She really stuck with it, and she really gave us something to consider of value. So welcome, Jade, and appreciate you being a part of the team.
Yeah, and I know she wanted to be here to help talk about the contest that we have going on. For the good news to share with everyone is if you sign up for understandingcbd.com, put your email address in there and sign up for our newsletter, which is also something that she's heading up with a weekly insider every Monday. It'll be sent out. You sign up, you also get a chance to win a bottle of Max and Stevens CBD oil drops delivered to your home once every month for a year.
For a year. That's a year's supply.
Yes. Doc Cheese volunteering some things. But we want everybody to stay with us because we're right back with our
buddy, Rossi.
Shorty Rossi. Stay tuned.
And welcome back to Understanding CBD with Max and Steven here every Sunday, 2 to 3 on WCBM AM 680. Quick phone number to throw out for you if you want to get in touch with us while we're on the air. The number is 410-922-6680. And I know you'll want to be calling us because of the guests that we have. Now, if you're familiar with that music at all, then you obviously watched his show. I think it was on Shorty about 2010 to 2013. Our guest is Shorty Rossi, star of Animal Planet's Pit Boss. He's an animal rights activist, proprietor of Shorty's Rescue, a fantastic guy. Shorty, I want to welcome you. We're thrilled to have you here, and I got to just start you right off. Why the passion about pets? I see your beautiful pity in the image that I'm looking at through the video. Talk to us about what makes pets so special for you.
Well, I mean, you got to have a passion for something else besides yourself. You know, whatever that may be, and some people do it in different ways. You know, for me, with a dog is different from a human because humans always are, you know, screwing you in some ways or whatever. You know, and I always say, you know, the most horrible animal on the planet is a human itself, and not a dog. And you know, they get such a bad rap. You know, they get, you know, especially the breed that we protect, a pit bull bully type breeds, that, you know, they're always misjudged. They're always, you know, saying that you know, their behavior is be born to kill. And, you know, and they don't understand, you know, people don't understand the breed. At the same time, they can't defend themselves. And I have a combination with, like, you know, being a little person, you know, with, you know, from being a scientific term is dwarfism. People are always judging me for being, you know, that I'll never amount to anything. You know, you're always going to be that Oompa Loompa, that elf, that leprechaun, or whatever. But I can open my mouth and put you people in place. And so I understand that being misunderstood, I understand how they are being misunderstood. So that's my passion. Yeah, tell them about it.
That's right.
Yeah, and you've really compensated by taking over. And your adoption business that you've run, and you know, in charity, if you will, because it's really giving back, is impressive. And you know, it's something I wish a lot of other adoption facilities would do, because if you adopt a dog from Shorty, you have to take care of that dog.
Yeah, or he comes looking
for
you.
Or he comes looking for you.
He's
coming to get you if you don't. And I think a lot of places don't. But just you know, from your perspective, Shorty, what's some of the big cause for abandonment of dogs? What are you seeing out there, well, are the reasons?
A lot of it, some of it is financial. They don't realize what they're getting into. The other thing is they think they can get the dog and throw it in the backyard with a bowl of water and food, and when they bring it around people or they bring it in the house, it's destructive or even aggressive because it hasn't been socialized, so they give up on it. I mean, right now during the Christmas season, it's, you know, let's get a puppy and then, you know, 3 months later, it's in a pound because it's cute when you get it. But when it's pooping all over the place and eating your favorite shoes, oh, it's not funny and cute no more. It's that's the bad thing about it. And even now with our pandemic going on, and people are adopting left and right because they need some type of companionship because they're not getting the human companionship that they normally get in public when going to work and going out to dinner or nightclubs or whatever you do. So, but what's going to happen when all of this is over, hopefully within the next 6 months to a year? Are they going back to the pound?
Yeah, but speaking of the pandemic, I mean, I'm glad you brought that up. So with coronavirus and everything going on right now, what's happening with rescue shelters? I mean, what's the scene like?
Well, let me tell you about us because, you know, currently that you guys probably know, I'm on tour right now.
Uh-huh.
And we're traveling the country by, you know, on an automobile and now a new donated trailer. And we're in Owensboro, Kentucky at a friend's house right now because yesterday when I got here, my freaking oil pan cracked. So I have to rent a car to go to a couple other events at shelters, then come back and hopefully my car is done by then. But with the pandemic is like what we had to literally reinvent ourselves because most of our income was coming by doing these events, these expos, like where we met you guys in one of the expos, either in Maryland or Virginia.
Yep, Maryland.
You know, Maryland, okay, at the World Pets Expo.
Right.
And, you know, that was like 70% to 80% of our income.
Mm-hmm.
And all that got cut. And so we really, you know, had to reinvent because I'm also in the cigar business, so I got that income coming in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, living in Mexico, the cost of living is just cheap, but we needed, and so when we really never did online fundraising because we were doing good without it, but now that we weren't able to do expos, fundraising events, we reinvented ourselves and, you know, we're surviving. And like even doing the road trip that we're currently on now, we needed sponsors to help us out. You know, to pay for gas, to pay for, you know, hotels. I mean, we got a hotel sponsor that's, you know, paying for everything. But, you know, but that's why we're going to do these. Because normally we will hold events at stores, at rescue groups, but we can't do it because of COVID. So by us going to these different shelters and giving them a possible, you know, reach to 1.2 million people on social media pages with, you know, who we're connected with, you know, gives them the opportunity to be, they're hit hard. Their donations are not coming in. Even though there's a high adoption rate right now, you know, they still have to, you know, make ends meet. Would you sit down, big guy? our boys here, obviously. He's like,
right,
you know.
So just for those that are just tuning in, we're here talking live with Shorty Rossi of Pit Boss from A&E and his...
Animal Planet.
There you go.
And you probably wouldn't mind A&E, would you?
No.
Yeah, of course not.
On a network.
You know? Yeah, exactly. And, you know, explaining that, you know, he's touring the world, the U.S. right now, helping to raise awareness and funds for the much-needed animal shelters, because with all the adoptions there, typically a couple months after that, when people realize the difficulty they're in with actually raising puppies, he's expecting, and everyone is expecting, they're going to need some help. So make sure, you know, we're going to give you some places to follow up with. And one thing, Shorty, with the behaviors of different animals that are adopted, obviously our show Understanding CBD, and just curious, you have experience with any of your pets using CBD?
We do, of course, and with your product too. We'll get into that in a second, but I wasn't really a believer in it at first. I was like, you know, no, you know, to me, nah. And then we had ended up bringing in this English Bull Terrier who had a complete anxiety issue, separation issues. I mean, people think he's getting murdered when he's screaming.
Mm. Wow.
And we understood why he was returned to the pound because he was breaking out of his kennels. And when we brought him back to our rescue, we picked him up in Central California. The Santa Maria animal, I can't remember, but it's up there somewhere. And when I was bringing him back, he was trying to break out of his crate inside my car. And I didn't know how he was going to be with the dog that was already in there. And, you know, we ended up having to zip tie everything. And we got him down there, and he was just completely losing it. So I went and took him to the vet the next day, and the vet goes, you know, oh, we're going to put him on this, you know, type of medication. I'm like, God, could it convict? But it'll take like, you know, anywhere from 25 to 30 days to completely work. I'm like, no, I can't deal with this for 25 or 30 days. And then somebody had mentioned CBD oil.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, so someone sent us and we started using it. It actually started working.
Imagine that.
You know, keeping them down, you know. And then we started using it for, we have a Dogo Argentino that's like 120 pounds, the size of a Great Dane, that he has, you know, skin issues and he has a paw issue where it doesn't allow us to put cream on him half the time because he's Cujo when you touch him. So, you know, he's a dog that we can never adopt out, but we started using CBD oil products and stuff, and it seemed to even help with his behavior along with the pain and everything. So, you know, we are now a full believer in it, of using the products. And then, you know, you guys sent us some samples, and we've already used that up on Kairos completely. My worker's like, where's more? I'm like, well, we got to work with them about that later on.
We got you.
Otherwise, use the other stuff that we got until, you know, until they send us a shipment. But, you know, and going through that. So, I was not a believer in it. I was more of being, you know, medication, pain medication, you know, psychotic drugs or whatever is the thing to use, which I was, you know, totally wrong. And even we use it too, is when, you know, we know the ones that are scared of fireworks, and down in Mexico, they don't need no reason to shoot fireworks. They'll just pick a day. Oh, it's a holiday today. Let's just blow off fireworks. So it's really, when it happens and you don't expect it, if there's a, by the time we administer the CBD oil product into them, it has a fast working, what am I trying to say?
Well, it works fast, you know.
Fast working result.
Fast working, sure. The question I had was, you know, how often, you know, of all the pets that you work with, do you have a favorite?
Of course, my boy that's on the camera.
I was going to ask you.
Out there in Radio Land can't see. He's my, you know.
What's his name?
It's been a while to find a replacement for Hercules.
Hercules.
On the show, and, you know, knew that, and we went through a lot of service dog failures. Because, you know, one issue or the other, one of them, you know, decided that since he got hit with a plastic bat from a kid, she no longer liked kids anymore. Mm. Well, that just puts that out of the picture. It's not a little cute chihuahua. It's a big pit bull. We don't need that type of issues. Another one, this had too much of an energy level and didn't want to pay attention. And, you know, then Francis, he got attacked a couple of times by service dogs, of all things, in airports. And so he doesn't want dogs coming anywhere like 2 or 3 feet from him. I mean, Francis is my boy, but this one here, a lady had 6 big dogs, and we're talking Great Dane, Doberman, Rottweiler, Great Pyrenees, you know, and she had to go from a house to a condo and ask me to find him a home. And we brought him back. We're like, oh, God, it's Hercules reincarnated.
Yeah. And you...
the white, you know, and I mean, we also use him at the rescue to test other dogs coming in because he doesn't have he doesn't react the way that a normal dog would be in attack.
Gotcha. You know? So would you say, and this just is a general question, when a dog uses CBD, does it impact the way they react to other dogs, would you say? Or how do you,
because if you're being a pain in the butt or if you're being screaming and everything, you actually increase the anxiety, the level of what's going on in the shelter. And then if you, and even me and the workers yelling at him, well, shut the hell up, because he's, you put him out in his kennel and he starts screaming. So we bring him out to a run on the side. No, he doesn't want that. And then you bring him inside to put him in a crate, and then he's happy in a crate. I'm like, okay, can we, you know, and every morning before eating, he's having a fit. And then they, you know, Poncho, which is one of my workers, you know, puts it. You know, he actually administers it directly. I said, don't put on his food. Just directly put it in his mouth.
That's what I was going to ask you. How do you give it to your pet?
Yeah, because that's important, too, because I know you're discerning taste and you don't just give your pets anything. Yeah. And there's a lot of different products out in the marketplace. Have you, you know, kind of gone through or do you have any advice for people that are looking for something to give their dogs?
Well, for the CBD oil?
Yeah, I mean, there's like pet treats
for
and...
Your product, for the Max and Stevens product, it is working better than the other product that we won't mention that we used before and, you know, still use what we have left and everything because, you know, with right now we have 26 dogs at our rescue and probably, I want to say, let's see, Mario, Tyros. 3 day dogs are on the product. And
are you taking notes, Max?
Every day.
Now, are you? Let me ask you: are you also using it for any kind of joint pain on them? Are you rubbing it topically on some aches and pains?
We rub it on, when they can, on Mario. And Radamantos. That's right.
Oh, Radamanto.
Yeah, Radamantos is our 17-year-old pit bull. I mean, we took him in when he was 15. We didn't think he was going to live that long, and I'm probably going to be stuck with him another 3 years. But he has leg problems, joint problems, and he takes it too, and he's able to move around when he does move, you know, more steadily, more easier.
I think that I'm just proud that we were able to help a pity named Radamanto. I mean, that's awesome.
Radamantos.
Radamantos.
Yeah, I'd like to get... through a lot of these names. Now, Shorty, we have a little bit more time on the show today. We got to take a break in just a minute. You able to hang on with us through the break and finish up? Because we have some more time today.
I don't know where my car's not even moving.
Oh, gee, you could have said something else to make us feel special, but, you know. Since you got nothing better to do, all right, we'll take that. So, everyone, we're going to come right back with Shorty Rossi from Animal Planet's Pit Boss, and we're going to continue the conversation. Please stay with us. We'll be right back. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Understanding CBD, as we are here every Sunday on WCBM live from 2 to 3. And today you're joining us in the middle of our interview with Shorty Rossi, known as the Pit Boss. And this guy is a boss, right? So we didn't get a chance to talk about it the first segment, but you know, Shorty has a cigar line, and there's something unique about the cigar line because he put his name on it. And we got a lot of questions for him about this because, as you know, Max, we put our name on our product, too.
We do, indeed.
So for us, it was a big deal. Shorty, what was it like for you to put your name on a product that is going to be out on the market selling? Tell us, did you just pick up anything and say, just smack my name on it?
No. I've been a cigar smoker for years. And I slowly became a connoisseur. I, you know, started to learn about it. And so in 2010, when Pit Boss premiered in January, shortly after that, I started, you know, contacting, you know, different cigar factories and tobacco companies and everything. And all of them but one came back saying, what can you do for us?
Mm-hmm.
One company because of what can we do for you? And I, you know, I got a hold of who is now a dear friend, Alex, and he's from Cigars International, which is one of the world's largest online retailer of cigars. And, you know, asked me what I smoked, and I told him what I was smoking. I like it. So he sent me some blends that have a new line that was coming out by the name of Diesel. And they already had a couple of cigars out. And I told him, I want something, you know, short and fat, and pungent, like Shorty, you know.
Well, like Max.
But, well, you know, there you go. And it's kind of funny. It's just like, you know, and they sent me back, and he goes, hey, we're going to send you to Nicaragua. I'm like, I'm not going.
Nicaragua.
Like, yeah. And that's
where they get good leaves, good tobacco there.
Yeah, that's where our tobacco is from. And so they sent me down to the factory, showed me how it was made. I got to learn how to bunch cigars, roll cigars. I mean, for years, I was going down there 2, 3, 4 times a year. And then lately, of course, rent can't go this year because of COVID. And last year, they were having an uprising, so we couldn't go last year. But the thing was that I didn't have to really invest financially. So this was a win-win situation where I wouldn't be losing money. It was supposed to be a limited edition cigar, and 10 years later, it's still being sold. We have two lines, the Diesel Shorty Original and the Diesel Shorty Punch, which, you know, they're both strong cigars, but they're, you know, they have my name on it. The proceeds, you know, not only do I get a royalty check from it, but they donate to our, you know, to our charity to help the dogs.
That's fantastic. Where do people get their hands on these? Do you sell them on your site?
Not,
yeah, go ahead.
They're not locally because, you know, we're not, you know, shared in, or store, excuse me, sold in every brick and mortar store. You can go to cigarsinternational.com and then just type in Diesel Shorty and they'll pop up. And even though you're buying them from them, you're supporting us and Shorty, because it's my only income I got right now. But it does go towards the animals too. So, you know, and it's a passion, you know. And then every, you know, it's just like you joke with people about it. Like this, yes, smoking does stunt your growth, And, you know, when you get people that want to be sarcastic, I said, I can be right with you. I said, but you're the one with
that's
the shorty.
That's good. Punch
mouth.
Back.
Yeah. They're like, you're the one with the shorty in your mouth.
Well, we watch some of your show. We know what you're capable
yeah,
of.
Yeah, we do. Yeah,
you
we
know,
definitely.
And I can also empathize with that process that you went through to actually make sure that it was the right thing before you endorsed it. I mean, again, it's a passion for Stephen and I in a similar boat.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's like fine wine.
Yeah.
You know, anything of your processing and going through it and fine coffee, it's a process when everything is done handmade.
Right.
Yeah, and that quality and attention to detail with your brand is important. As it is for us, and I think that's one of the reasons why we connect so well with you, not just the great sense
of
humor and
good product.
Fantastic
I mean,
looks.
And we're using it at our rescue. You know, we vouch for Max and Stephen's product.
You know, we always talk about it because people are typically using it for themselves, which, you know, I encourage you to do. But the pets specifically, I mean, it's just such an enormous opportunity to help out your fur babies. You know, Stephen and I are both dog owners, you know, and we love our pets. I mean, they're a part of our family, no doubt. So we can empathize.
Yeah. And I think that's just one of the things, you know, I know we're coming closer to the end here in the segment. And I wanted to really kind of take it back to, obviously, we know that hemp can help and cannabis can help the dogs. But I think the biggest thing we need right now is for everyone to hear Shorty's message that he's traveling across the country telling, which is, you know, pets are great. They do great things for you. And right now, they need our help. There's the shelters, the people that take care of pets are really in some trying times. So, Shorty, what do you say, you know, as we're trailing off to the end here, what, you know, tell people how they can help the most and what is it that they can, because one of the biggest problems that I hate is people making donations and then that money not going really to the organizations
right.
that need it.
How do they get it to you directly, Shorty? Yeah.
Well, directly is follow us on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram at Shorty Rossi. I mean, you can watch the live videos that we're doing on this tour because we're interviewing, you know, each shelter we go to and asking how they need help, and there's information about them. And you also, you know, so on Facebook, you can donate to, you know, on our Facebook page, or you can, you know, go to our PayPal account, which is paypal.com. paypal.me/shortiesrescue to help us out. And at the same time, go to our website, shortiesrescue.org, and there's a donate button. You can also see what we do. I mean, we just don't rescue these dogs. We have our own free spay and neuter clinics in our community, free vaccination clinics, and, you know, we do so much more. I mean, we have a pet store in Mexico that funds our rescue called Shorty's, you know, Rescue Pet Store.
Shorty, we have to wrap up. You are a gentleman, hopefully a friend for the future with us. We appreciate you. Thank you so much for joining us. This means the world to us, and hope to talk to you soon. We're going to take a break right now, and then when we come back, the segment we like to call
Mailsack.
There it is. Shorty, thank you very much.
Thanks, buddy.
We appreciate it.
You're the best.
Talk to you soon.
And now more of Understanding CBD with Max and Steven on Talk Radio 680 WCBM.
Welcome back, everybody. Understanding CBD with Max and Steven. Give you that quick phone number one more time for this final segment, 410-922-6680. Steven, how amazing was that interview with Shorty?
I don't know, man. It was a lot of fun. He's a cool dude.
I just love talking to him and getting to know some of the things that he's doing. But without further ado, the segment that everybody's always waiting for, Noah, cue up the wheels of steel. What's it called?
Mailsack.
My man.
You got mail.
Talk about being on point. Noah had his finger on the button, ready to go with the mail sack cue. Noah, props to you, my man. Very good. Very good. All right. So coming into mail sack, this is the part of the show where we finally get to talk about our company. Steven and I own Max and Steven's Premium Hemp Extracts, and this segment, mail sack, is when customers reach out to us or anecdotal stories about usage of our product, et cetera, et cetera. So when Steven and I typically prepare, we go through some of these things, and I had a query from a customer.
Yeah, I wanted to definitely make sure we talk about this because it's an issue that a lot of people have, and customer reached out to us, and what she said was, so Max, you mentioned that there is a sweet spot that I would find. What does that mean?
Yeah, very interesting. Right. So, yeah. And so she reached out. It's a very legitimate question that we get very often. So the sweet spot, it's interesting. You're talking about a plant. You're not talking about a pharmaceutical. Everybody's body is different. Everybody reacts in a different way. Everybody has a different result. CBD is biphasic, which we don't talk about nearly enough.
But it's basically a big word for you,
it's
Max.
A big
that's
word
scientific.
For me. Thank you. And what it means is that different things affect your body at different dosage in general. So her question was, what's the sweet spot dose for her? And what we always recommend is, because again, we can't predict how everybody's going to react, we suggest starting very low and be consistent about it. Stick with it about 7 to 10 days, about a week. See how your body feels. If your body feels like it could use it a little bit more, use a little bit more by all means. If for whatever reason you feel like you need to tone it back a little bit, tone it back. Remember, there is no lethal dose and there is no harmful effect. At the end of the day, it's just about the way that this plant interacts with your body. And what most people find is not only does it help them with the stuff that's very obvious to them, but many times it helps them with things that they never had an understanding that they had a problem with.
Yeah.
Such as people take it for things like arthritis pain and then realize that they're actually sleeping better as a result.
Yeah.
So the moral of that story is stick with it. You will find that sweet spot, and eventually you'll come back to us and let us know what that is.
Yeah. And in finding the sweet spot, as Max mentioned, it could be different things that you've noticed, so be open-minded and play with it. That means you may try what we suggest, starting with a small serving. As it grows, you may try backing down sometimes a serving just to see where that sweet spot is. So it does take a little bit of time to do it, and you know.
Or increasing the frequency. Sometimes what people find is if they do it more often throughout the day. I believe you use it that way.
That's how I use it. Yeah. I mean, I use small servings. I'm a big fan of a quarter dropper, a quarter of a milliliter, and I do that as needed throughout the day. Sometimes it's four times, sometimes it's five times, sometimes it may be twice, because if you're not thinking about whatever it is that your issue might be and it's not becoming a problem or you know, it works.
But you have to notice the subtleties.
Right.
Notice the subtleties.
Right. So, but now it is a mail sack day, but we're talking about pets here. So, Max, we got any pet stories we can share?
Yeah, a couple. So, I mean, other than our own stories about our own furry friends, and everybody that's been listening knows that Steven's dogs, Nil and Coco, use our product, and my dogs, Rufus and Reginald, use our products, and they both love
Reginald.
It. Reginald, that's his aristocrat name, right? Right, Mrs. Mailsack, right. So I have a story, because I was at, I saw recently a relative that's going to be doing an extended trip across country, and she's got an older dog. Dog's about 17 years old. You know, getting up there in age, and the dog gets very anxious before it gets in the car. I'm sure, you know, even Shorty can relate to that, and so can you. And she was asking, how do I make that dog a little bit less anxious? So CBD is certainly something to consider. There's no question about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, right?
A lot of people have questions about dosing on CBD for yourself or pets, and we have it on our website. We can also share it another way, but it has a dosing chart, which was beautifully designed, and it helps people understand where to start if you generally have different types of conditions, and you know, same for humans and pets. So for humans, we would say a quarter of a milliliter as a dropper, and pets are much more sensitive.
Right,
much more sensitive. So you're talking about one or two drops, and actually we didn't get to this with Shorty, but one of the when we sent him a bottle the first time, someone put a whole dropper. Gave the dog a whole dropper.
But it's important to mention that the dog just got tired.
Yeah.
And relaxed.
And good news, there's no lethal dose.
There's no lethal dose.
So we've been back to your biphasic comment, whereas you take a little bit, you get one result. You take a little more, you get a different result. If you're getting too drowsy from CBD, it may be a sign you're taking too much. And we are out of time, Max.
Right. So visit us, www.understandingcbd.com. On that website, we've got great articles about dogs, pets, and really anything CBD related. Remember to call us or text us, 443-743-2444. No more farmers market for us. Get in touch with us personally, and we'll be happy to help you.
That's right. That's
Thank you, audience.
And
lovely Sunday. Go ahead.
Sign up for our newsletter at understandingcbd.com. You'll get on our list to win. And next week, we have Stephen Elmore, a great guest.